谢谢马可弟兄。
Happy 2024.
弟兄姐妹们，2024年新年快乐。
I hope you all had a good week this year.
我希望你们有2024年第一周过得很愉快。
Around this time of the year, there is a lot of introspection and there is a lot of making a resolution for the new year.
每年到这个时刻，我们都有很多的自我反省，并且在新年也觉知。
My first accomplishment in a new year is a clean workspace. Can we see the picture?
我今年头一个成就就是来清理干净我的工作的空间。
With the help of my son and the donation of his old computer, I managed to set up a clean space to do my work.
我的儿子给我他的旧的电脑，还有帮助我来建立一个干净的工作空间。
It may not look like much, but then you haven't seen it before it was clean.
你看起来好像不怎么样，可是呢，你如果你看见我在清理之前我桌子的脏乱，你就知道这个是一个很大的成就。
So as you can tell, one of my New Year resolution is to be more organized.
所以弟兄姐妹，我今年的决志就是要今年要更有条有理。
As a church, we also want to do some introspection and vision casting.
所以我们在教会一年的开头，我们要做一些反省，我们要对我们意向呢有要一些检讨。
We're thankful to God that our church was able to put in a new roof and a lot of new floors.
我们感谢主，在过去的一年给我们一个新的屋顶，给我们一个新的地板。
We had at least 72 visitors, and 13 of them got baptized among us.
去年居然有72位访客，其中有13位接受相信主，受洗归入主的名下。
And we began to have physical cell group instead of only online cell groups.
我们开始有实体的小组，不仅仅有线上的小组。
We added three more cell groups, New Life Cell, Country Cell 2, and Cantonese Home of Love Cell.
我们有三个新的细胞小组，我们有新生命小组，我们有乡村二组，我们有粤语的这个粤语之家的这个小组。
We started an online English class for English learners.
为着这些学习英文的弟兄姐妹，我们也开设了线上的英文课程。
And we had our first children's summer program.
我们也举办了头一个儿童的暑期的活动。
We had another successful Christmas shoebox event where we made and sent out 205 boxes of gifts to poor children around the world and accompany them with our prayers and blessings.
我们也很成功地举办了一次的圣诞学盒的活动。我们为了世界各地这些贫困的儿童们，我们制作了并寄出去205盒的礼物，并且呢，我们为了这些礼物献上祷告和祝福。
As a whole, our church was able to send out about $17,000 for missionary support. Considering the size of our church, that's not a small amount.
去年一年呢，我们还送出去一万七千美元作为宣教的工作。如果你考虑到我们教会的规模，我们是一个小小的教会，我们能够献上这个数字，其实呢，算是有很大的贡献。
Thank you, brothers and sisters, for your generous offering. And please know that the money that you offer every Sunday doesn't just go to maintaining our church. It also go out to help other organizations and missionaries around the world.
我们真的很感谢我们的弟兄姐妹这种很慷慨的奉献，因为这个这些奉献呢，不只是维持我们教会的开支，并且能够把福音传到其他的国家去。
And what I just cited, they're not accomplishments to boast about. We're not boasting about anything. You know, they just represent our joint effort to minister to our community and to minister to our Lord.
我们不是在这里夸耀我们自己的成就，乃是，这是代表我们为着社区、为着主来，共同努力。我们感谢上帝，让我们有这种的成就。
We say these to give thanks to God and to all of you, to all of us who participated in this effort.
我们要感谢上帝，我们要谢谢我们所有的弟兄姐妹。
In 2024, we hope to do more and better because we are all growing.
今年2024年，我们希望能做得更多，做得更好，我们也都一起在主里头成长。
Looking back to 2023, it was a time of strengthening and rebuilding our structural foundation. We focused on the rebuilding of our cell group church.
所以我们来回顾2023年，我们实在是在巩固教会，在建造教会基础的这一年。我们很注重来建造我们的细胞小组，我们为了这个缘故呢，我们希望能够做得更好，做得更多。
So we in this coming year we want to do continue that and we want to do more, and we're rebuilding our church. And this coming year we're rebuilding our church under the theme of seeking true knowledge.
所以今年我们要用寻求真正的知识来做我们的 主题，来做我们的重建跟发展教会的这个主题。
Yes. Next slide. Okay. Yes. God told Daniel around 600 BC that in the end times, knowledge would increase.
我们的神在主前600年前就告诉他的先知但以理说，在末后的世代呢，人类的知识要加增。
Indeed, we see that it is such is the case. Our world is filled with all kinds of knowledge and information right at our fingertips.
我们看到我们这个世界实在是充满了触手可及的各种的知识。
Information comes at us through the mail, movies, news, YouTube, Telegram, Twitter, now X, and our emails.
我们看到我们这些的资讯是透过我们的邮件、影片、新闻、YouTube、电报、推特、电子邮件这些东西来传达给我们。
Does it take you a good half an hour just to clean up your email?
很多时候你要来清理这些的邮件呢，你要花个半个小时。
With some people, it may take even longer.
有许多人还要花更多的时间来处理这些电子文件。
In addition to all this, now we have AI, artificial intelligence.Which could produce even more information and knowledge in the space of just a few seconds or minutes.
除了这些以外呢，我们现在又有人工的知识，在几秒钟、几分钟之内能够产生更多的资讯和知识。
What is scary is that we don't know whether or not to trust the information it puts out because we don't know.Who is controlling the process?
更可怕的是，我们不知道应该怎么样去相信，所提供给我们的这些的资讯，因为我们根本不知道在背后是谁在控制这些资讯。
An AI church is already in existence in Germany. Can we show the clip?
所以现在在德国呢，已经有德国的教会已经有人工的这个智慧的聚集。
已经有人工的叫人工智能的教
会。This is what it looks and sounds like to attend a mass led by artificial intelligence. Hundreds of churchgoers attending that service during Germany's Convention of Protestants. The 40-minute service was put together by a 29-year-old theologian and philosopher from the University of Vienna. He says 98% of that mass was the product of ChatGPT, but the congregation said the avatar just didn't have the warmth
yeah,
that
you
you're used
that,
to,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
All right.
你看这个这个人工智慧的这个教会呢，四十分钟的这个聚会里头呢，有许多的内容都是用人工智慧去操纵。
Oh, that was from the pastor. He said that right now in AI church, in a 40 minutes service, everything is controlled by AI. AI can write your sermon for you.
它这个人工智慧呢，可以替你写你的讲章。
It could make songs for you.
并且呢
write songs for you.
制作敬拜中所需要的音乐。
It could lead you in prayer.
它可以带你祷告。
But is God in it?
可是神有没有在其中
？Is there any soul in the sermon?
就是有没有这个属灵的意味在里头呢
？Would you rather?That I spend time to pray before God, seek His will, ask for His wisdom and His direction in knowing what to say to you? Or would you prefer that I just issue a command to AI to tell it to produce a sermon for you?
你所需要的这一种这个讲道是哪一种的讲道呢？难道你不要我去寻求神的旨意，去祷告，看神要给教会什么样的教导，什么样的方向呢？或者是你情愿来跟着这个人工知识的智慧的这种的潮流，只是对这个机器发出一个命令，它就制作一个很美好的讲章。
Are we seeking more knowledge, knowledge to scratch our itching ears, and like Paul said in 2 Timothy 4:3 to 4? Can Lily read this verse for us?
因为时候要到，人必厌烦纯正的道理，耳朵
发痒，
就随从自己的情欲，增添好些师傅，并且掩耳不听真道。偏向荒谬的言语。
No, it is precisely because there is so much false knowledge floating around that we need to focus on knowledge, not the knowledge that mislead, preoccupies, and lulls us to sleep, but the knowledge that edifies us, the true knowledge that protects us from deception.
所以外面就是有这些很虚假的知识，所以我们就是要小心，因为我们所要的是真实的知识，不是那些误导迷惑我们的知识。
Apostle Paul, Apostle Peter, they both warn us against false teachers arising in the end times that will misguide and mislead us.
所以保罗呢，就来警告我们说，在末后的时代呢，有一些这些虚假的这个知识呢，它会误导我们，是迷惑我们。
In Romans chapter 1, verse 28 to 29, it says,
罗马书第一章28节、29节，
他们既然故意不认识神。神就任凭他们存邪僻的心，行那些不合理的事，装满了各样不义、邪恶、贪婪、恶毒，满心是嫉妒、凶杀、争竞、诡诈、毒恨。
This is the result when we do not know God. This is the result, the direction mankind is going.
所以呢，如果我们不认识神。这就是人所走的道路就是这样。
In Psalms chapter 11, verse 3, it says this.
根基若毁坏，义人还能做什么呢？
Our enemy Satan would use all the forces in this world to confuse us, to distract us, to destroy our foundation of faith. But we need to stand firm and be reestablished in our foundations.
所以我们的仇敌撒旦在末后的日子就是要来毁坏我们的根基。我们的根基被毁坏的时候，我们就没有办法为神做什么事。
So we see false knowledge corrupts, but true knowledge will protect and set free.
所以我们就看到错误的知识会腐败人，真正的知识才能够保护人并释放人。
What is the knowledge we seek? Not just any knowledge, but true knowledge.
什么是真正的知识？不是任何的知识，乃是真正的知识。
True knowledge is the knowledge of God.
真正的知识就是对神的认识。
In Proverbs chapter 9, verse 10, it says,
箴言第九章第十节，
敬畏耶和华是智慧的开端，认识至圣者便是聪明。
The mistake that Adam and Eve made in the Garden of Eden is that they desire the knowledge of good and evil.
亚当跟夏娃在伊甸园里面所犯的错误，就是说他们渴望得着分别善恶的知识。
They found its fruit to be delightful, even desirable.
他们发现那树上的果子是令人喜悦的，甚至是令人向往的，是令人渴慕的。
God placed them in a perfect environment for them to commune with Him, but they were not satisfied with the knowledge of God. They wanted and desired to taste the delight of sin, of disobedience against God.
神把亚当跟夏娃安置在一个非常完美的环境中，让他们能够跟神做亲密的交通，可是他们不满于对神的认识，他们想要尝尝那个悖逆神罪恶的这个最终之乐。
This year we will seek to know our God in a more grounded and more intimate way.
今年呢，我们一定要定义来寻求神，能够更扎实的、更亲密的来认识我们的神。
Brothers and sisters, why is the fear of the Lord the beginning of wisdom?
弟兄姐妹，为什么敬畏神是智慧的开端呢？
Because there is just so much of God that we need to learn.
因为关于神，我们还有许许多多关于神的事，我们需要认识知道。
Before I knew Pastor King, the pastor before us, I was a little afraid of him because he always had a very serious face and he is very authoritative.
在我认识我们从前的金牧师之前呢，我其实有点怕他，因为金牧师总是很严肃，很有威严。
But after I had gotten to know him, I discovered that he is fun, he's kind, he's extremely smart, and even a little mischievous.
可是后来当我认识金牧师之后呢，我觉得他这个人很有风趣，很善良，很聪明，可有时候也很调皮。
I remember we used to go to a co-worker meeting with him every week. And at that time, Ian was quite small. He was maybe 3 or 4 years old.
Well, 我们从前在母堂服事的时候，我们每一个星期都在母堂，我们都相聚，一个礼拜一次相聚。那时候我的小儿子差不多是四五岁吧。
And Ian would be playing around under the table.
所以我们在 聚会的时候呢，蔡师母、金牧师、金师母，还有我跟师母，可是我们的小一眼就在我们的桌子底下自己在那边玩。
And Pastor King would tell Ian, "Go time."
所以呢，我的小儿子呢，就金牧师就跟我的小儿子Ian说
，Yeah，he would tell Ian to go tie up the shoelace of Pastor Tsai。
他说你要跑到蔡牧师那里去，把他的那个两边的鞋带都挤在一起。
But then Ian was also a little naughty, so he went and he tied up the shoelace of Pastor King.
所以我的小儿子呢，伊恩，他也那时候也是很调皮，所以他就听金牧师的话，他就把金牧师的这个脚的那个的这个鞋带呢绑在一起。
I think that for those of us who know Pastor King, we would all agree that he is such a wonderful man, and we have all come to love him so very much.
所以过去我们认识金牧师的人，我们都非常的喜欢他，我们都很爱他，我们也想念他。
Much more than we fear him. It's the same with God. We started with a fear of God, but as we come to know him more and more, you will grow to love him. Love him with your whole heart.
所以我们跟我们的天父神也是这种的关系。起初我们说不定有点怕他，可是我们越来越认识神的时候呢，我们是越来越爱神。
We still fear him and honor him, but we love him.
所以呢，我们就会来遵从他，我们就会来更爱神。
And what is true knowledge? True knowledge is knowledge of his son, Jesus Christ.
第二点，真正的知识呢，就是来认识神的儿子耶稣基督。
Ephesians chapter 4, verses 11 to 14.
他所赐的，使使徒，有使徒，有先知，有传福音的，有牧师和教师，为要成全圣徒，各尽其职，建立基督的身体，只等到我们众人在真道上同归于一，认识神的儿子，得以长大成人，满有基督长成的身量。
This year we want to know the Son, so we may be like him, so we may mature and please our Heavenly Father.
弟兄姐妹，我们今年我们就是要来更认识耶稣，我们更像耶稣，更像耶稣那么样的成熟，让父神得到喜悦。
The Bible tells us that all the mystery of God is hidden in Christ Jesus. All of God's treasure of wisdom and knowledge is hidden inside of him.
圣经告诉我们说，神的奥秘就是耶稣基督，一切的智慧，一切的知识都隐藏在主耶稣里面。
So let us be founded in that knowledge.
所以我们要竭力地认识神的儿子耶稣基督。
True knowledge is also knowledge of God's love.
真正的认识的知识也就是来认识神的爱。
Philippians chapter 1 verse 9.
我们请丽丽来读《腓立比书》第一章第九节。
我所祷告的，就是要你们的爱心在知识和各样见识上多而又多。
Our love can only be inspired by the knowledge of God's love.
我们认识神，就能够来激发我们对神的爱。
It's only after.I got to know God, that I realized how shallow my love really is.
当我真正来认识神的爱之后，我就觉得我自己所有这种的爱是多么的肤浅。
I hope that by learning more and more about the love of God, that we may all become better lovers of men, of our families.
所以当我们更认识神的爱的时候呢，我们更能用神的爱去爱人，是爱我们的家人，爱我们的弟兄姐妹。
This year, I hope that we could be inspired by the love story of God as we find it across history and in the pages of His holy book.
我们今年，我们盼望我们从我们的历史，我们从神的话语，更能来认识神的爱，更能来激发我们的爱。
True knowledge is knowledge of God's will.
所以真正的知识呢，也是来自认识神的旨意。
In Colossians chapter 1, verse 9 to 10.
哥罗西书第一章第九节跟第十节。
因此，你们自从听见的日子，也就为你们不住的祷告祈求，愿你们在一切属灵的智慧悟性上，满心知道神的旨意，好叫你们行事为人对得起主，凡事蒙他喜悦，在一切善事上结果子，渐渐的多知道神。
Brothers and sisters, each one of us has a calling on our lives.
弟兄姐妹，我们每一个人都有从神来的呼召。
God does not make garbage.
上帝不会制造垃圾。
We are each made by Him, saved by Him.And called by Him for a purpose.
我们每一个人都是神所创造的，神所拯救的，神所呼召的。神有他的目的。
Life would be meaningless unless we live out that purpose.
我们人生没有什么意义，如果我们没有活出神呼召我们的旨意。
God has a purpose personally and collectively.For us and for the world.
这个神对我们个人，还有对我们的集体，神有他的目的。
We're so relieved to, you know, we're so relieved to leave the old year and to begin a new one, because we are hopeful for better times.
我们离开了旧的一年，进入新的一年，我们也盼望我们今年能够活得更美好。
But will the new year bring better times?
可是新的一年会带来更好的时光吗？
We have been sorely disappointed for the past few years.
过去的几年，我们有很多的失望。
It seems like each year is worse than the previous.
我们好像是每况愈下。
It is about time that we seek and be grounded in God and in knowing His will for our future.
所以今年的一年，我们需要来寻求神的心意，我们要在神的里头扎根。
Only if we do that will we be secure and not afraid.
所以我们如果这样做的话呢，我们才能够得到真正的安慰，能够稳固在神的里面。
He is the God yesterday, today, and forever.
神是过去、现在、永远都是同样的，他是不改变的。
The things that we do not know in the future are in His hand.
我们的未来，我们的这些未知数都在神的手中。
And we are in His hand.
我们也的确是在他的手中。
Only He is the anchor for our souls.
只有神才是我们灵魂的锚。
And in Him we will find comfort and protection.
所以在神的里头，我们要得到真正的安慰和保护。
And why do we need to seek knowledge, true knowledge? Because we need it for ourselves.And for others.
所以我们要来寻求真正的知识，是为着我们自己，而为着他人。
In Hosea chapter 4, verse 6, it tells us.
何西亚书第四章第六节。
我的民因无知识而灭亡，你弃掉知识，我也必弃掉你，使你不再给我做祭司。你既忘了你神的律法，我也必忘记你的儿女。
The prophet Hosea gave us a stern warning from God.
先知何西阿向我们发出来自神那种非常严厉的警告。
God said that his people should know him, and when we do not, we perish.
神说他的子民应该认识他，可是当他们不认识神的时候，导致他们的灭亡。
His word also tells us that we're supposed to be his priest, responsible for teaching others about him so that they may enjoy the blessing of God.
神呼召我们是要做他的祭司，我们的职责是要教导别人来认识神，使他们也享受神的祝福。
We need to invest ourselves in the true knowledge of the Lord for ourselves' sake and also for our children's sake.
所以为了我们自己，为了我们的孩子，我们需要真正的来认识神。
The sacred knowledge of God needs to be passed on from generation to generation.
神神圣的旨意是要代代相传。
We cannot rely on AI to do that.
我们不能依靠人工的知识来做 这些事。
It's not about sounding or looking good. It's about conveying the truth of God from the Word of God and as inspired by the Holy Spirit.
并不是听起来很动听，看起来还是蛮好的，而是要传达来自圣灵神的话语，神的真理。
Jesus had said that the knowledge of the secret of the kingdom of God is given to us, his disciples, not to the onlookers, not to the rabbles around him, and definitely not to ChatGPT.
耶稣说神国的奥秘的知识是赐给我们，我们是他的门徒，不是是给那些旁观者，那些无关紧要的人，周遭的乌合之众。
而且特别不是
给，而特别不是 ChatGPT。
是 ，He had chosen us to be His priests.
神拣选我们做他的祭司。
In Malachi chapter 2 verse 7,
马拉基书第二章第七节，神的话说。
祭司的嘴里当存知识，人也当由他口中寻求律法，因为他是万军之耶和华的使者。
Let us make sure that we are not like the Pharisees, whom Jesus accused as hypocrites, who knew the law but did not practice it, and ended up becoming stumbling blocks for others to enter the kingdom.
我们千万不要像耶稣所说的那些假冒为善的法利赛人，他们能说却不能行，他们知道律法却不去遵守，最后成为别人进天国的绊脚石。
We need to proclaim the word of God, and we need to obey it. We need to work it out.
我们听神的话语，我们要能够持守，我们要能够行出来，能够帮助别人。
And we are not to be like the Israelite who circled in the wilderness for 40 years because they knew not the ways of God.
我们不要像那些无知的以色列人，他们在旷野漂流了40年，他们不认识神的道路。
In Psalms 95, verses 10 to 11, it says,
所以诗篇第九十五篇第十节跟第十一节说，
四十年之久，我厌烦那世代，说这是心里迷糊的百姓，竟不晓得我的作为，所以我在怒中起誓，说他们断不可进入我的安息。
Brothers and sisters, let us learn from the lessons of those who had gone before us, both from history and from scriptures.
所以弟兄姐妹们，从过去的历史，还是从走在我们前头的先人的教训之中，我们要来学习。
2024 will be a year full of challenge.
弟兄姐妹，2024年将是一个充满挑战的一年。
It will be a turning point for our country.
这是我们国家的一个转捩点。
The coming election will determine the destiny of our country and even of the church.
今年要到来的总统大选将会决定我们的国家和我们教会的前途。
Those who know the Lord must choose wisely and stand with the Lord.
那些认识神的人必须要很有智慧的选择并站在主的这一边。
We're not for Democrats, and we're not for Republicans.
我们现在不是在宣传民主党或者是共和党。
We're for the Lord.
我们是要跟主站在一边。
We need to know Him and His ways in order to walk with Him.
我们要认识神，认识他的法则，才能够与神同行。
This is such a crucial year for us to gain true knowledge.
所以今年是一个关键的一年，我们真正的要来寻找真的知识。
Knowledge of God.
对，认识神的知识。
His Son.
认识神儿子的知识。
His love.
认识神爱的知识。
And His will.
认识神旨意的知识。
I'm excited to.Come on this journey with you.
我很高兴的能够踏上这段的旅程，跟弟兄姐妹一起寻求。
To seek and know who is my God.
来寻找，来认识我的神是哪一位。
Who is His Son?
谁是神的儿子。
How He loves.
神是如何的爱我。
And what is His will?
神的旨意何在。
He is true knowledge.
神才是真正的知识。
He is the truth.
神才是真正的科学。
He is true science.
所以神才是真正的科学家。
Not 科学 science. The word science means knowledge.
所以呢，科学就是即是知识。
He is true science, not Dr. Fauci.
所以神是真正的。Science, 真正的科学，真正的知识，不是法吉博士。
So this is what I ask you to do. I would like to invite you to do.
所以呢，我今年我邀请你们来跟我一起做这些事。
Please join us in prayer every day.
所以每天我们都要一起来祷告。
For the revelation of His knowledge to us.
所以让神能够。把他认识他的知识来启示给我们。
Because it is Him, it is He who gives wisdom and knowledge.
因为是我们的神给我们真正的智慧和知识。
And He promised to be generous if we will be faithful to ask.
神答应我们，如果我们是出于忠实的这个祈求，他会慷慨的赐给我们。
Join us every morning from 7 to 8 o'clock on our line chat.
每天早晨七点到八点半呢
Monday to Saturday.
我们在我们的这个 line 上面呢，我们都一起祷告。
Monday to Saturday.
所以从星期一到星期六。
We will worship with music, with songs.
我们晨祷呢，我们会敬拜神，用诗歌歌曲来敬拜神。
We will read scriptures.
我们也会读一些经文。
But most of all, we will pray. We will pray to know Him more and more.
更大多数的时间呢，我们会一起来祷告，让我们借着祷告能够越与神越来越亲密，更认识他。
Secondly.I'd like you to ask if you could find one person, at least one person, to partner with you to read God's word daily.
我第二个请求呢，是希望弟兄姐妹都能够找到你读经的伙伴，让这些伙伴能够每天跟你一起来查考神的话语。
If we read four or five chapters a day, we could finish the Bible in one year.
如果你一天能够读上五章的圣经呢，你一年你就能够把圣经从头到尾读了一遍。
I think inside your bulletin there's an insert of a Bible record. So if you read the Bible faithfully, you can just check it off.
我们在
and know if you had completed it.
我们在教会里头的这些册子，在这册子分发给你们的册子里头，你能够读到这个读经的这个顺序。
The church also has a Bible reading group that started last year around Chinese New Year. And you may join this group if you cannot find a partner to read with you.
弟兄姐妹，如果你找不到你自己的祷告读经同伴的话呢，我们从去年的农历新年开始，我们就有一个读经小组哈，所以弟兄姐妹你可以去参加这个小组。
It's in WeChat.
所以就是
在微信上有一个群，
在微信上的这个读经小组，
我们是一年读经一遍，所以弟兄姐妹也可以参加这个群。And inside that group, you're free to ask questions and you're free to share your insight.
所以在读经小组里头呢，你可以问问题，你也可以分享你自己的读经心得。
Thirdly, I would like to ask everyone to find a cell group. To belong to.
第三呢，我希望弟兄姐妹每一个人都找到你的细胞小组，都能够来参加小组。
Surround yourself with like-minded people who will seek the Lord together.
你能够找到一些志同道合的人，一起来寻求神。
Let us come back to God's word.
所以我们再回到神的话语之中。
Let us not put it aside and do our own thing.
我们不要把神的话语搁在一边，只要自个人做个人的事。
His word holds the truth that we have to live by.
所以呢，神的话语就是真理，是我们生活的准则。
We have to rediscover our foundation.
所以呢，我们要读神的话语，用让神的话语做我们的这个信仰的基础。
So that we may know how to worship and follow Him.
所以呢，让我们怎么样能够来敬拜神，能够来跟随神。
Can we